Sound effect, right? That's that new stuff right there. We live and we back, man. Welcome back to the Cookout, man. I'm the voice, Pastor Q, man. Thank all of y'all for tuning back into another Thursday of the Cookout, man. We got something fresh on the grill today. We got Fade to Green, man. Entertainment, record label, man. Everything in the house right now. They're going to come and bless us and let us know what they got going on. We got our whole star cast from DJ Al Freeze. Miss Sophia in the house, Christy, Chris, Cousin Greg in the house, man. We missing a few today. Tevin, get well. And everybody that's made the Cookout a success. Shout out to my homies out there, DeMarco, Solo, my man Gene, Jakar, Autobody, and all those that continue to support the Cookout. So listen, man, first thing first, we're going to definitely go to a word of prayer, man. Allow God to be able to bless us, man. And if you don't believe, just keep your eyes open until I finish. Father God, we thank you, Lord, for all things you're doing. Thank you for blessing us. Keep us, oh, Father God. Allow us to be a blessing to the show here today at the Cookout, Father God. Bless our guests, allow our topics and everything to be cool and informative, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Well, that's what's up. Al Free, what's going on?
What it do?
Al Free mic'd up today.
Checking out the new mic, man.
He be talking, y'all can't hear him, so now he got his mic, so now he good. Now he's live and he is back. He's back.
I'm trying to get that Morgan Freeman voice. You ain't got to see me.
Morgan Freeman just keep narrating stuff, man. That's what's up. Sophie, what's going on?
Chilling, y'all. What's up?
That's what's up. That's what's up, man. Chrissy, what's happening?
What's up?
That's what's up, man. Listen, so, man, we got a good thing right now. We got the CEO, the rapper. She says she wear many hats, man. So I'm going to let her introduce everything she do, man. Up here with me next. Let me let y'all see my guests here live on Facebook. We got Shifty. Shifty, what's going on?
Ain't too much, man. Just grinding and trying to make some things happen, man.
That's what's up. That's what's up. So listen, how did all this start?
As far as just everything.
The music. How did y'all come together? I know it's family involved and all that. How you even get started with it?
Well, for me, I started doing music. I always was kind of like into music. I come from a family of musicians and singer. My mom was a singer. My dad played the lead guitar. Mm. So I came from, you know, musicians and stuff. So I knew I was going to do something in music. So what ended up happening is I started out just playing around. First, I used to sing. But I just kind of stopped. I got into hip-hop, and then it was just a rap with that. So started doing my music, and then I started learning more about the business.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of times people get in bad deals because they don't know the business side.
Right, right.
They just think it's just about the artistry. So I wanted to learn the business. So went to school, took a little business management classes and stuff like that. And then I had met up with Black China's mother. This is Sogyo Tony.
Okay, okay.
She used to be my manager.
Oh, that's what's up.
Yeah, shout out to Black China and Tokyo and all that. But yeah, she used to be my manager, so
You talking about Rob Kardashian, Black China?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I know there's a lot of Black Chinas I be seeing on the brand.
Black China, yeah.
Yeah, I know there's a lot of different Black Chinas. Yeah. I'm trying to make sure it's the right one.
Dream and King, yeah.
Okay.
So I did some business with her, and it became a thing where since I knew a lot of the business, it started as me being her artist, but it's like we became partners because I knew too much. It was like, you should be my man. So we ended up doing a promotion company on my grind entertainment.
Mm.
And we promoted artists and did different events for artists and stuff like that. And then we did a radio show together, On My Grind Radio.
Mm-hmm.
That was down there at WLVS, Listen Vision Studio. So we did that for a couple of years. And then I just kind of branched out, went our separate ways. And but even with her, we did a lot of humanitarian things. We went out and fed the homeless. And
that's what's up.
Cali and went on Skid Row. And it was blocks and blocks of people outside with tents. It's just unreal. It's some stuff you would never believe until you've seen it, you know what I mean? So I got into helping too, like with different nonprofits, Sister United, and helping the seniors get food every month and, you know, feed them and stuff. Because a lot of times we forget our seniors. You know what I'm saying? We get older, get so involved in our own lives, we forget about, you know, the people that raised us or look out for us. So always, anytime I can, I get back. You know what I'm saying? I work with a lot of different nonprofits and doing a lot of community things. I worked with Mayor Bowles on her campaign, former councilwoman to Ruby May for Ward 8, and I do a lot of stuff like community stuff, activities and stuff for the kids. We did a trunk or treat for the kids in Southeast.
Mm-hmm.
We did it so that instead of them going knocking on doors, you know, they can just come to the cars and stuff. We had a big parking lot over by the big chair, and I coordinate all the entertainment and all the artists and everything, and they had food out there. It was really nice. And then I just was like, okay, well, I want to do some more stuff with, you know, like entertainment, period. So I ended up doing my own radio show. Shout out to Red Zone Radio.
Mm-hmm.
And so I was pushing, you know, my radio show, giving artists a platform just like y'all are giving artists
that's
a platform.
That's what's up. That's what's up.
Mm-hmm. And just trying to, because it's been a lot of killings and stuff going on.
Yeah.
So it's trying to get them off the streets and, you know, help as much as possible. So I do my due diligence and, you know, help people out, support businesses, local businesses, DMV clothing designers, conscious crooks, you know what I'm saying? So, like, it's just about supporting. That's what I do. I network and support with everybody. But, you know, everybody kept saying, you should be my manager, because they like, how do you be? You've been 3 different places at one time. when do you sleep? I mean, so it just became a thing by me knowing the business and knowing the artistry side of it. I took on a couple artists and we're trying to build. We're about to build. It's our time now. So Fade the Green up in here, you know, I got Neek the Freak, Madam T, LG the Black Girls, he not here yet. And shout out to my people that's not here, Louie Lotto, Bob Dylan, and Stacks the Major. But yeah, it's Fade the Green, we out here, we working, man. We trying to push it to that next level and actually build the DMV up the way it should be. That's why I say I do a lot of things. Outside of that, I promote some Bliss and book artists for their clubs and stuff and Power and Eden.
That's what's up.
And I do a lot of event hosting, so.
Yeah.
So I'm just a little bit in everything. That's why I said.
You got your hands in a lot of bags.
Yeah, man. Give me all them bags, man. Give me all them bags. Hold up, man. I'm on a cookout, but I don't see no grill.
This the type of cookout that is BYOF. You bring your own food.
Damn, I ain't never been no cookout.
You ain't
like
read
that.
The fine print. You just showed up.
Man, I go to the cookout. I'm gonna smell some ribs and some burgers or something.
Y'all on the grill. That's the cookout. Y'all is what's cooking. That's the concept of it. Y'all was on the grill. That's the concept. You on the grill right now.
I had to say that though.
You know what I'm saying?
I had to
mess with it. Nah, it's all good. Joke well taken. It's well taken. Since you learned the business, right? How important would you let artists know that's out there? That how important is it to in learning the business as to honing your craft?
I would say definitely learn your craft, you know what I'm saying? Because I just had some artists on my show yesterday, and they would have forgot the lyrics of the song. And it got a little kind of crazy because they stopped instead of just keep going and stuff. And that's in the business, you got to
keep mess going. Up. Only you know you mess up.
Right, yeah, exactly. That was a point. That was a point they were making. But yeah, I know your craft, but the business, it's like 10% artistry, 90% business. And when you out here, you know what I'm saying, you want to sign these record deals and you don't want to get caught up in a situation to where you're signed but you're not moving and your stuff is being shelved. And to be honest, a lot of record labels really now, they're not really looking for artists to clean up. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like back in the day, they was grabbing artists, giving them all these bonuses and signing them.
They want finished product right now.
They want you when you don't need them.
Yeah.
It's more so once you're at that level to where you're already making money. They want a piece of that. So then they'll be willing to sign you. But I mean, independent to me is the way to go because it's more your money and then you have more creative control.
Yeah,
so definitely learn the business. It'll keep you abreast to how to carry things too. If you ever have a manager or you deal with other people in the business, you'll know how to carry things. Because a lot of people out here are very unprofessional. And they don't know what's required. Like, even with managers, they don't know what's required. Managers, they don't know the difference from booking agents. You know what I'm saying? They kind of like think like this back in the day, okay, I'm just going to pick you up and just pay for everything. You know
how important is it to have a manager, though?
No, I think it's important. Reason being is that you have someone to help you, guide you, you know what I'm saying, along your journey. Because a lot of times we don't know the business, so you need somebody to help you, to, you know, give you, put you in a direction where you can get more opportunities and stuff like that. But it has to be somebody you trust, you know what I'm saying? Because just like any other business person, a manager can do you bad too. So you just got to be, you know, keep your ears to the streets, know what's going on, learn the business, trust the person you with, pick somebody that you trust. I say that, I can't say that enough. Pick somebody that you really feel like gonna have your best interest at heart, you know what I mean?
So even you say even a lower level, a small scale, somebody just getting started, you say they need a manager?
Somebody on a lower scale?
Like getting started, you know what I mean? Like,
well, if you just get started, you need to get your craft straight.
You need the craft first? Okay.
Yeah, you need to get your craft first because think about it. What is the manager going to manage?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I've been meeting people sometimes. They're like, yeah, I can come on the show, but I got to talk to my manager first. I'm like, who are you? Like, what do you do? I'm not trying to be funny, but why did your manager got to dictate you coming on an internet radio show? I mean, ain't that serious. You know what I mean?
Yeah, so exactly. It's like, if you're just starting out, you need all the exposure you can get. So it's if you get an opportunity, you're supposed to jump on it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we meet a lot of people, man. Even Al Free and Tay, we get a lot of people like, man, the show ain't big enough for us. But my thing is about, you know, the situation is that if you want to make it out here, I don't care if it's just one person who find out about you. You should want to come do it. You
know some saying? People, they let their egos get in the way and they block their blessings.
Right. But yeah, my thing is like you said, if it's just one person that's going to hit me and find out about that, I should want to do it. What's up, cuz?
Yeah, that's
my real cousin right there.
See, got your family.
My whole family in a small world. Cuz, what you doing?
This is LG.
Oh, man, yeah, that's my real cuz right there. What's up, cuz? What's going on? What are you doing here? Yeah, I didn't know he was an okay. This is a small world. Real
family
in the house.
Now it's a real cookout.
That's a real cookout. You know,
hey, you're supposed to put the food.
Yeah.
Cousin Pete supposed to bring the food.
Right.
Yeah. Okay, cuz. Real family in the house. That's what's up. That's what's up. Well, listen, we're going to go to a quick commercial break, man, while we try to chop it up here. We'll be right back in the cookout, man. Y'all stay tuned. We live and we back and we back and we live, man. Welcome back to the Cookout. I am the voice, Pastor Q, man. I'm in here with Fade Degree Entertainment, man. All the artists up in the house, even brought some family along. Small world, so watch what you do in these streets. Next up, man, we got Neek the Freak. Neek the Freak, what's going on, man?
What's going on?
Yeah, get the mic. Neek, how you get the name Neek the Freak, man? We want to know, man. What is Neek the Freak, man?
It all started with Go-Go.
It all started with Go-Go?
Because I'm a beast on the drums, so.
Oh, yeah?
My band members started calling me Neek the Freak.
What band you playing for?
I was playing for Rock Mentality, man.
Okay, okay.
Right, since then, I just ran with the name.
That's what's up, man.
But rapping, that was before Go-Go.
Okay, where you from?
Northwest,
that's what's happening. All right, man, Uptown in the house, Uptown in the house. So how long you been, what do you rap, sing, what you do, let them know?
I rap, I can sing.
And you said you play the drums too, right?
Yeah, I can sing if I put myself up to it. I choose not to.
I can sing in the shower too, nigga. I ain't gonna lie to you. I sound good in the shower, man. I do, man. Yeah, but
I think I'm better than Chris Brown in the shower.
You know, and in the car by myself, you know what I'm saying? But that's what's up, man. What advantage you feel like you have, man, knowing how to play the drums and then doing the rap side of it?
Because I have a backup plan regardless.
Okay.
Like, if rapping don't work, like, regardless, somebody's going to hear me playing the drums somewhere.
That's what's up.
So if the rapping doesn't work, I can still fall back on that. Other than that, I can work on a car better than anybody I know. So as long as cars are still effective, I will always have a job.
They definitely be effective, man. You know what's good, man? I hear a lot of y'all doing more than one things, and they saying that's how you be successful out here. You got to have more than one thing that you do. You know what I'm saying? You ain't it's good.
More than one craft.
Like you say, man, you say you play the drums, you work on cars, you say, I mean, it's about, you know, being able to be multitasking what you do. You know what I'm saying? Don't limit yourself to one thing, I guess.
Can't box myself in.
Yeah. You know, it's like an athlete, too. I think I always thought an athlete should just try to play all sports. If you're an athlete, you can play anything.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And they help you, whatever you do, like football players play basketball players play football.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You guys should be able to mix
just
it up
like
a little
in high
bit.
School, in the off-season for football, you go to play flag football.
Exactly.
You join the basketball team.
Exactly, I don't think you should limit yourself to just rap. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You learn how to play an instrument. Learn to play the keyboard. You know what I'm saying? I just think you raise you and increase your value by doing that.
Yeah.
How long you been with Fade the Green?
Almost 2 years.
That's what's up. How long Fade the Green been around, period?
Probably 2 or 3. I mean, I've been locked up, so a lot of things have changed since then.
You write your music while he's locked up?
I don't write.
Okay.
It's one thing I won't do.
Hold
I can write you a song, but
hold
it won't be by me.
Hold on. Are you saying you
I don't write none of my lyrics.
Man, hold on. Let's get an instrumental.
let's get an instrumental
because he don't write.
Throw me something nicer than
that.
I can't
go over it. Give him something with some bang because he don't write. He don't write. So that means he getting ready to give us something off the top. Because he don't write.
That's
Jay-Z and Biggie thing, man.
Hey.
You know what I'm saying?
Learn from the best.
Yeah. Listen, man. Neek the Freak getting ready to give us something live here at the Cookout. No pen, no paper. Straight off the top of his head, man. We getting ready to get it, man. Al Free gonna give him something hot, and he gonna give us something hot. Here it come.
Sit back, you know I got that kickback. Aim it at your head and then I bust your big back. Talking to the white me, running like you hype me. Running through the hood like a white man, you know can't jump me. I don't do no running, y'all niggas know that I'm bumping. Talking with the 40 to 30 clipping is nothing. I don't do no bluffing, I aim it, I'm never cuffing. I'm talking about the season, I murk you for no reason. When I stepped up to the game, I was only 12. I done been locked up, and I done slept in cells. Had a cold night, talking to my mama. Aim it at your head, I'm trying to take you for this drama. I ain't got no beef, I'm the baddest little butcher. Doing this shit, you'll get pumped like Ashton Kutcher. And I'm a killer with these verses. And your body riding in them long black hearses.
Ow. That's what's up, man. Neek the Freak in the house, man. Listen, man, Nick just gave us something fresh off the dome, man. That's what's up. Nick. We appreciate that he alive. And Nick said he don't write nothing. So when you go, the gift to be able to not be able to write, right? So when you go to the studio and you lay the verse, you want to, you first taking it then. First take Stephen A.
I'm taking it all in one take. I don't want you to re-record nothing.
Uh-huh.
If you have to re-record something, it should only be a punch in for the hook.
That's what's
up. Put a
up,
hook
man.
On it. Because I'm going to freestyle the whole song. You cut out what's supposed to be cut out mm-hmm. to make it a verse.
Man.
The way I recorded my first song, my engineer called me. I was mm-hmm. random. He's like, man, I got a beat. If you're serious about getting in the studio, come holler at me. Came to his house right then and there.
Mm-hmm.
Laid the whole track down and left it there.
Like, wow.
You mastered it. I'm going to leave.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to leave and come back. When I come back, it's going to sound like something. I know it is. He was like, all right, when you come back, all you got to do is put the ad-lib on. That's nothing. A couple of little sounds. You can repeat them.
Let me ask you this. I mean, I used to rap a long time ago, but is it when you say, like, you don't write, is it true that different beats create different energy? Because me, when I remember when I used to rap, right, yeah. the beat give you the words in a way. It give you the feeling.
That's
you know what
why,
I'm saying?
That's why I
yeah,
stopped.
The beat give it to you. You know
that's
what I'm saying?
That's why I stopped my writing, because then now I got to find the exact type of melody.
Yeah, because normally you got to take some lyrics and put it to a song. But see, when you hit a beat.
When it comes to my head, it's like, all right, now I got to put it to this beat.
Right.
If I write it, I gotta put it to this beat. I can't let nobody else get this beat.
Yeah.
But if I just think about it, all right, you can give me 6, 7, 8 beats.
And different words gonna come to all different beats. Yeah. I'm hip. That's what's up. So where you at in your career right now? You got something recorded? You got something on iTunes, SoundCloud? What is it?
Right now I'm working on all my legal documents for everything.
Okay.
So I can just start pushing.
So shift you got you on the business side.
Oh, yeah.
That's what's up.
Yeah.
Let me ask y'all a question real quick. What are some of the most popular, I guess, mistakes new artists are making right now as far as the business side?
They're
signing their life away overnight because
somebody
with the money is throwing them a contract.
Right, right.
Like, I don't care who you is in the game. You can be the biggest mm-hmm. label right now. You throwing me $100 million, I'm reading all of the fine print before I even think about signing anything or even sending it to my lawyer.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a reader. Because then if my lawyer tell me something that I wasn't already thinking, you fired too.
Right.
You got to go. Because then that means you want me to sign this life away. No. I'm not signing my life away into nobody's contract.
Record deal starting to be like high interest rate credit cards.
it's like a work insurance policy on yourself.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Because like, everything they're going to front you up front, you paying them back. So basically, that's life insurance.
Right.
That's to secure you to be alive. Because now you're paying for security, you're paying for studio time, out of everything they already gave you. So you mm-hmm. basically don't go, you don't leave, walk away with nothing for it until you start touring. Mm. If you're not touring or getting booked for shows, you're not making the money. Streams is free all day now. You just paying for the site you're streaming it off of.
You think the streaming and the new technology has made it better or worse for artists?
It kind of made it both better and worse.
It made it rest for record stores because I don't remember, there is no more record stores, is
it? I remember when people used to stand in front of record stores like they stand in front of Foot Locker for some doors.
Exactly, yeah.
Just to wait for albums.
I mean, I remember right here in this very mall, you had Kent Mill.
Yes.
You know, Waxy Maxy.
Yes.
You know, yeah, little places you can go buy music and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying?
You don't got them places no
you
more.
You don't have them places no more.
Best
I mean,
Buy barely got CDs.
Yeah, I mean, people don't even have CDs. CD's about to be extinct, you know what I'm saying?
Okay. Just like DVDs with the Fire Stick.
Exactly. Everything going to be digital right now.
DVDs
right.
The Fire Stick.
I'm still buying DVDs. I mean, you never know.
You say you still buying DVDs?
Yeah, right. How long is they going to continue to make DVD players after the Fire Stick?
Exactly.
It's already took over in the last 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
I just want a Blu-ray. Don't come for me.
You just get the Blu-ray? Bless your heart. Bless your heart. Bless your heart.
And I have.
And look, sooner or later, they're going to have Blu-ray TV. You need to come with the slot already on me.
You guys get you a VHS, Christina, for real. Man.
I got VHS too,
though. For real.
Don't play. I still got a TV.
You still be rewinding tapes and all that stuff.
Oh, God. No, I don't be rewinding those.
Do you rewind them after you watch them still? Or did you leave at the end and wait till you...
I don't be watching them. I just got a VHS tape player.
Now you just have one. With your fingers.
Yeah, good God, man.
I still got junkyard tapes from back in the day.
So we need to free... What else going on? Are you performing anywhere local? Y'all got anything coming up?
Hopefully soon.
Okay. Yeah, we got a couple things coming up. Well, we have a show. It's called... It's called Culture. And, we're going to do it. It's going to be at Studio 126. It's going to be out Alexandria on August the 18th. And we're looking for vendors and also any type of person that's into art, music. It's going to be like a networking mixer and a fashion show. So, and we're going to have artists perform, of course, nationally. Of course, my team going to perform. And also hosting the Cash World Part 3. They're doing a rap showcase, and that's coming up too this month on the 25th. So we're doing that. We got a lot of little stuff we're working on. We still, and then we're working on a Fade to Green mixtape, which we're going to do as a team. So yeah, so they got their own individual things they're working on, and we got collaborative things we're working on.
Well, that's what's up. Need to free. Tell them where they can find you at. Give them your Facebook, your Twitter, IG.
Facebook, Mob Love Miko. Instagram, IM_MeekTheFreak, P2G.
Okay. Well, that's what's up. Okay, somebody got a question?
I'll get it from you later.
Oh, okay. So, what you got over there? You got any questions over there?
Oh, no.
Okay. Alfred, you got anything over there for NeekTheFreak?
Yeah, I got a question.
What you got?
Your musical influences. Who'd you grow up on? Who are your favorites?
Who'd you grow up on?
Who are you riding around to?
Who was forced upon me?
Who was forced upon you?
If I had a choice, I probably wouldn't have been listening to nothing but growing up. That's where I'm from, D.C. So that was the music I really grew up on. Right. But at my dad's house or my uncle's house, it was East Coast, West Coast, and Big West. Mm-hmm. It was between Biggie, Pop, and Bone Thugs. I was like, no, I'm lost. I don't know who beefing with who.
Right.
I don't know which side to take. You know what I'm saying? But my biggest influence right now is like the only person that I can sit and watch interviews about and things like that would be Kevin Gates. I feel like he speaks on the same aspect and principles that I live on. Like we've been from the same things in different areas, different neighborhoods, but we went through the same type of stuff. Prison, shot, stabbed, whatever you want to call it, drug dealing, anything. We've both been through it. So I understand everything that man says, word for word. Even if he starts to speak Arabic, I understand that word for word.
You speak Arabic.
What's the big controversy behind Kevin Gates, though? No, where people over some more Kevin Gates. What's the big controversy?
They don't understand that man has his own mind. He's not influenced by nobody's opinion on him.
Right.
Bring him the facts. Like, it's just like me. Prove to me certain things in history actually happened.
Right.
Before I will actually sit down and say, all right, you telling me the truth. Mm-hmm. You can tell me the sky's blue all day, but until I see that it's actually blue, I'm not gonna believe it.
Respect.
That's what's up. Well, look, man, we're gonna take a quick commercial break, and man, we're gonna have another member, man, come up from Fade to Green live here at the Cookout. My main man, DJ Alfred, Sophie in the house, Chrissy Chris, and Cousin Greg, we in the house, man. We be right back here live at the Cookout. Oh, yeah, did you get it?
I didn't get it yet. You sent it to the email?
Yes,
I sent it. Oh, wait, it just came through. Are you going to be able to download it, Alfred? Or you want me connected from here? Since there's no Wi-Fi. Okay.
All right.
Oh, Senate? Okay. Just sent it.
Live, we back, man. That's that new Joan Diamond Dancing by Neek the Freak. You heard it here first live on the Cookout. Neek the Freak, man. Get that Diamond Dancing, man. Definitely a hot track. Next up, man, Fade to Green. We got Madam T. Madam T, what's going on?
What's up with your Madam T in the building? Southwest Queen, Fade to Green. You hear me?
Oh, we got Northwest, then we got Southwest. Yeah. We all over the old DMV in here. That's what's up. Already. Madam T, where that name come from?
My grandmother. May she rest in peace. She gave me that name.
Grandma named you Madam T?
Yeah.
Where that come from? What's the history behind that?
Ball seed, my shrimp. You feel what I'm saying? I protect my mother. And mind you, just saying that, like, just these past couple of days of last week, I went through my mother being in a coma for, like, 3 days.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
And I had to even stick
through that and even stay tough with protecting my 5 siblings, letting them know every day that my mother was okay, even when I didn't have faith. So Chaney wanted me to come. She told me to take care of my mother, but I felt like if I continue on doing what I'm doing, I'd be more happy, you feel me?
That's what's up. That's what's up. So, man, you're a sacrifice.
I just want to thank God for her even waking up.
Yeah, that's what's up, man. How long you been doing music?
Since I was probably like 5. Mm-hmm. Mary J. Blige is one of my favorite singers, so that's what I grew up on.
Okay. You sing and rap?
Yeah. I don't prefer to sing, but I do a little bit, but I prefer to rap. But whatever, when I'm in the studio, I just let it flow.
So like a lot of rappers, they got a way of singing then.
Yeah.
You know, it's not like Luther Vandross type singer, but it's like, you know, they
I'm
sing a song.
On that type of level, though.
Yeah. Who's some of your inspiration as far as rap? Like, who do you kind of look up to?
Left Eye.
That's what's up.
Queen Latifah. Mm. Roxanne.
You went to the old, you listen to some of the greats now. I thought you were going, young, I thought you was going to say like, you know, Nicki Minaj or something like that.
I'm a 90s baby, so.
Okay, so you.
I say Mid-X, Missy.
Okay.
I forgot about
Mid-X. Like I said, MC Light. Too much. Foxy Brown. I even like Lil' Kim.
I don't feel so old now, man, because then the rappers I used to listen to, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I thought you was
going to
listen
to them. I like just stay,
the classic.
Yeah. They was more into what they was talking about back then.
Okay.
So nowadays, everybody's just going to talk about this and that, but ain't really got it. We should just be trying to do better for the youngest.
So you more so some consciousness, some message in your music?
Yeah. I ain't perfect, you feel me?
No, this ain't a job interview. We just talking about
I don't really curse in my music because I know I got siblings and family members that listen to it, so I don't try to put too much of that in.
Mm-hmm. How does that help you not putting curse in the music?
Actually, like I said, I came a long way. At first, that's all I used to do. Mm-hmm. Thinking it was really going to get you somewhere, just me learning myself, my music, and finding out who I am as an artist helped me to not really do that, because it's really not good for your brand or your music. They have the clean and the dirty version, but I'd rather keep it clean.
I heard a lot of artists say that the profanity give the music more of a feel.
That's what the mindset thing. Like me, that's not where I'm at with it. I think that's why a lot of the society of the youngins, the way they is.
Right.
I think it's cool, so I don't know. That's in my own lane with it. I don't judge nobody. Do what they do, I do what I do.
That's what's up. What you got outlet now? Like, what your project and your music career? Then you got some stuff online?
Yeah, I got a couple of songs. I got one that's called No Friends, on a Free Site Anthem, Prophet. I have a mixtape on Spinretta called Southwest World Volume 1.
Mm-hmm.
Working on some collective as a team right now and working on my solo project.
Okay. You say you've been rapping and singing since you're like 5 years old?
Yeah. I grew up in a house with like 14 aunts and uncles. So, yeah, that's all we did.
That's what's up, man. Madam C, man. That's what's going on, man. Well, I think we got a track from here. For you. What's the what track we got? What track we got from Madam C? No Friends. Talk about. Give us a little bit of little history behind No Friends before we get that popping.
Well, what's crazy is even writing this song is like I spoke it into existence. The dude that shot my video named Kilo Ivory, after he edited and put my video out, like 2-3 days later, he got killed shooting a video for some other artists. Uh-huh. It's basically talking about, you ain't no friends of mine, you ain't no enemy either, but I really don't trust you, but I let you do you feel what I'm saying?
Understand.
And just like her, losing my grandmother, losing a lot of men, and free my uncle Wayne Perry.
Oh, Wayne Perry, like, your uncle?
Yeah.
That's what's up, that's a good man. Yeah, good man. That's what's up, man. We gonna play, what is it called, No Friends?
Yeah, No Friends.
We're going to play No Friends, and then, man, after No Friends, we're going to come back, and we're going to play a little bit of it, and we're going to talk about it. This is No Friends Live here on The Cookout by Madam T.
Y'all feel where I come from. Y'all feel where I come from. Everybody go do something. I ain't lying.
No, I ain't lying, no enemy, but you no friend of mine, friend of mine.
No Friends by Madam T. That don't dope. I hear a lot of the pain in there, man. For real.
Yeah, man.
So, yeah, you yeah.
Know, I forgot to say Tupac was one of my favorite rappers.
Yeah.
Everybody say Biggie, but Pac Passion.
Okay, okay. That's what's up, man. That's the two of the greats right there, man. You definitely got some great influences. So that's definitely what's up. So what you got? You got anything?
I was going to ask, like, when did you know, like, this was what you wanted to do?
My grandmother knew I could sing, to be honest. I wasn't really into the music at first. I was playing basketball. But before she died, we used to, like, listen to beats and record songs and videos. And after she died in 2010, June 4th, I just took the shows out there.
So that kind of motivated you to push you forward to want to do it more?
Yeah. I didn't want to let her down. So she already sang my title before I sang. So that's why I want to do it even more.
You do anything else besides rap, Tony, man?
Let me see. Take care of my family. Mm-hmm. Take care of my mom. The main thing I want to do is just doing this music thing. It can be a gift and a curse.
Mm-hmm.
But the gift about it is how you can go about it. What you get out of it, you can give back. And that's what I'm at with it. I ain't doing it for the glitz and glamour or just to shine. Like, God put everybody in position for a reason. We gotta help each other.
That's what's up. That's
purpose
what's up.
And the mission.
What's the hardest part? I mean, it can grind me. Doing rap from DC. Does go-go music itself help hurt DC rap artists?
Nah, I don't really think so. The artists hurt themselves. The image they put out. So.
Go-go, really a big piece of go-go rock. Is rap music, though, right? Isn't? Am I right about that? I mean, isn't go-go basically rap music?
Nah,
not
really.
It's not really. So, I mean, but every time I hear go-go songs, go-go songs I recite.
Yeah, it's different.
It seems like go-go takes a lot of R&B then, right?
I guess so.
Yeah.
That's
everybody. Yeah, it seems like it seems like every time I listen to Go-Go, they've taken something from an artist or something. But you know what? Don't get it twisted too. You know, the Missy Elliott's, the Jay-Z's, and people of that have dipped into Go-Go and stolen from Go-Go. So you don't go, but you know, but Go-Go definitely seems like finding a hit song and put it to a Go-Go beat.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you look at the Booed Up remix, and you know, so everybody's probably, every song that come out, somebody's trying to find a, put a crank behind this joint, you know what I mean?
I want to say something about what you said about
that. What, get your mic.
I said, I wanted to say something about what you said, dude, her artist, the Go-Go. Mm-hmm. I have a different view on it.
Okay, what you got?
Okay. I grew up in I'm a city girl, too. I'm from Northeast and Southeast.
So. Hold up, we got Northeast, Northwest, Southeast. We didn't go to this whole city. All quadrant, right? All man, quadrant. We got everybody in this dump.
So, like, think about it. Growing up, you know, just hearing Go-Go, when I was more into hip-hop, it did kind of hinder hip-hop, because it's like, when you're going in the Go-Go realm, it was like, it's a different style of rap. I mean, the rappers, they rap too, but it's just a different, whole different vibe. So if you a real person that's really into lyrics and really want to be on your Jay-Z thing or your pop thing, you know, it kind of, you know, for a long time too, I think with hip-hop, DC wasn't embracing when it came to hip-hop. It was more so because DC was the foundation of Go-Go. So hip-hop, they was like, So for a long time, that's why they didn't really pay attention to hip-hop artists. And that's why a lot of the hip-hop artists didn't have places to perform at, unless they were doing Go-Go.
That's true.
Because we didn't have as many places. They didn't they didn't have places. The big spots were all the bands. So that's why I used to jump on with the bands and stuff, and rock with the Go-Go bands. So that's the only way to get my introduction with my own music. You know what I'm saying? Just to be able to do my rap stuff. So it does, it has affected, but I say now we have evolved.
Yeah, because I'm going to tell you what, man. DC is definitely way more hip-hop than it ever used to be.
That's what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying?
It's way more hip-hop. Because I remember one time, Go-Go dominated the city.
Exactly.
But you know what changed? What I think did that too? And it's a small thing. A lot. Me and some dudes talk about it every now and then. When people like Mark Bonds and the club promoters from like New York, LA started coming to the city, they started creating clubs where Go-Go's couldn't play.
True that.
So basically what they did is they kind of raised opened up the market for hip hop. Like if you notice, like Mark Bonds is a promoter, he don't really have too many Go-Go's play there. You know, then you know, remember this city had a bad rap with, every time there was a Go-Go somewhere, it would get rowdy, somebody get shot. So a lot of times people like, they ain't want Go-Go. So what it did, it opened up the door for neo soul, hip hop artists and stuff like that, because everybody equates Go-Go with violence. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know what, somebody said, listen, you want to have something, and you want to have something that's cool, clean, and everybody come do their thing and have a good time, you can't have Go-Go.
Right.
You got to have, and so now what they've been doing is even throw you in, DJs are pop. I'm going to tell you what, I think there are more DJs now than ever. I mean, back in the day, it was only a handful of DJs. You're storming on with your thing, you know what I'm saying?
True.
Like that. But now, you know what I'm saying, it's a lot of DJs. You know, because people would rather have a good DJ than really to put, you know, the risk in having a band.
Right.
You know, so like, man, give me a good DJ. A DJ put that thing together for me and have a party with, up against getting a band or something like that. But
the artists have more chance of getting their music played.
Exactly.
And more exposure for indie artists.
Yeah. So it definitely helps, man. Right. So that's what's up, man. So let me wrap this up with Madam T. So Madam T, where can they find your music? What's your Facebook, Instagram, Twitter? What's the handles?
You can follow me on Instagram, Madam T _, SoundCloud, Madam T, Twitter, Madam T, everything Madam T you can find me on.
That's what's up, man. Shout out, man, to your uncle, man. Definitely a legend. Good dude, man.
Yeah. In sight, too. That's my brother doing the bed right now.
That's what's up, man. Well, listen, man, we're going to take a quick commercial break, and we're going to be back here live with, man, Fade to Green. We're live in here. We got one more coming up. Pastor Q live up in the house, man. I'm the voice. We're going to go to a quick commercial break. We'll be right back at you. Nico Frigo over there putting some moves on. Oh, nigga, let's get you, man. Oh, Nico Frigo show us some moves, man. Get Nico.
All the girls see them. Look at his kicks. Look at his car. All I say. Look, mommy, I know you. So good. Clap at your soul.
That's Nico Frigo, man. Man got many talents, man.
I'm not your companion. Or your man stand. Don't hit me when you want to get rammed. I'll be scrammed. That's right. With lots of mobs. Shot for lots. And scalps. But she liked the way I did it. Beat that.